My name is Eugenio Morales. I'm from Colombia and this is my job. I do. Nothing special, but it feeds the family. I got it made. I got the power, the money, and the respect. My problem started with the Mexicans. You see, they think they can rule everything. The only thing wrong with that is, they mess with the wrong man.
Mexico, give it to ya. Wait for you to get it on your own. Mexico, deliver to ya. Knock, knock, open up the door, it's real. Hit the non-stop, pop out, and stainless steel. Go hard, getting busy with it. But I got such a good heart that I make the motherfucker wonder if you get it. Damn right, and I do it again. Yeah, I am life, so I got to win. Break bread with the enemy. No matter how many cats I break bread with, I break who you send to me. You motherfucker never wanted nothing but your life saved. Come on, that's on a life day. I'm getting ready. We're gonna pop, then we gonna fall. Then we let it pop, don't let it go. Give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya.
Never been looked at before in their wild and natural habitat. My name is Luis Martinez, and I am a documentarian, and I like to film animals.
Hi, I'm Harold Razo. I'm with National Geographic.
Alright, so now we know what we gotta do. And that is, we gotta chase after this dinosaur-like creature named the Archosaurus. It normally sleeps. And he works with the National Geographic in Mexico, that's why the camera fell over.
Hi, and welcome to Lab Safety, the Do's and Don'ts. If you are watching this video, chances are you are in a chemistry classroom, or perhaps you have downloaded this off of LimeWire. But either way, this video was created to instruct you, the viewer, about a few important chemistry safety rules. Now let's take a look at a group of students and try to figure out what they're doing wrong in this lab experiment. Let's pause for a moment and take a look at the first big mistake the students have already made. Notice how neither of them are wearing aprons or goggles. These are a very important part of lab safety and should not be neglected. Although they do look funny and kids make fun of you for wearing them, remember, you're protecting your eyes and your body from dangerous chemicals. For the sake of time, let's fast forward this a little bit. In the event of anything ever spilling in the classroom, make sure you tell Ms. Flint right away. Ms. Flint despises students that choose to spill things all over the floor. She does not pick them up. She makes you pick it up. And you won't like that. You know why? Because she basically turns you into her own personal bitch. Now the students did have a few screw-ups during the experiment, but other than that, they did a fantastic job. Now let's take a look at a few safety rules you may not have heard of. If you do not follow these safety rules, you may end up dead, like many past chemistry students. Remember, if anything ever happens to you in the chemistry room, Ms. Flint will not care. She will merely have your body dragged out and put into her basement. Never eat food while performing an experiment. In case anyone in the classroom ever catches fire, remember to reach for the fire blanket as fast as you can. If not, then this person will burn and die a horrible, painful death. Always remember that the eyewash station and the shower station are on the same pole. These are to be used only if you are on fire or if you have something in your eye.
Alright guys, we're going to be having an experiment, so I'm going to need you to go get your goggles and your aprons and then go to a lab table, okay? So can y'all do that?
Remember to always walk, not run, in the chemistry room, or else you and others may end up getting hurt. There is no excuse for any horseplay during experiments. Sniffing markers is never a good thing. Remember to always wear closed-toed shoes and never sandals during an experiment. If you choose not to follow these rules, Flinty may decide to eject you from the classroom. Now this is a tip for the guys. If you choose to take your girlfriend to the back room and try to make out with her, you will be unsuccessful. Do you know why? Because Flinty will find you. Remember to never leave an open flame on, or else someone like Hiro may come along and try to cook their sandwiches on it. For those of you who decide to abide by the rules of the chemistry lab, you will be the ones who have the most fun in this class. You might even get a chance to play poker with Ms. Flint. And now it is time to move on to the stories of the children who decided not to follow the safety rules. First up is Luis Martinez, born June 4th, 1943, died May 22nd, 2006. Now Luis wasn't a very popular student. He was an angry boy, hated the world, but he loved chemistry. He loved it so much, he studied every day. But he always studied too much. The work was so overwhelming for him, he could never really accomplish what he wished to accomplish. So one day, his little brain just gave out, and that was the end of Luis Martinez. And now we move on to a one Kevin Beth. Kevin had everything going for him. He was a musical prodigy, a mathematical genius, two-time world champion in discus and shot, was the captain of the football team, cross-country team, track team, and volleyball team, as well as a model. Now Kevin decided to take chemistry during his junior year, but Kevin found chemistry to be so hard, so difficult, that he just could not take it anymore. Mason Biamonte was the man. He had ladies, he was smart, he was athletic, he could pull hose like no other, but Mason didn't like chemistry. He signed up for it, but he didn't like it, so he didn't listen to the rules. This was a very bad idea. Whenever we would do experiments, Mason would never listen. He would always do what he wanted. Never what Ms. Flint wanted. Always what he wanted. Why? No one knows for sure. Maybe it's because of his hair. Supposedly his hair took control of him when he was 6, causing major brain damage. Most doctors are surprised he's not a vegetable. One day Mason thought it would be funny to play around with the Bunsen burner. Here is actual footage of Mason's real life burning. This is why you always must be careful when playing around with the Bunsen burner. Katie Mueller was also one of chemistry's victims. Katie loved chemistry, but what a lot of people didn't know was that she could not read. She never told anyone because she was embarrassed, and because so, she never learned the safety rules. So one day, when she was working with hydrochloric acid, she accidentally spilled some on her hands. She merely washed it off and continued working. The next day, Katie came back to school, and everyone was shocked. Her skin had turned green. Katie, of course, did not notice because she never looks at herself in the mirror. But when she got to school, she was teased by all the other students. Never again did Katie Mueller ever return to school. She took a plane to Jamaica, where she now lives with 23 monkeys.